ضد اسلام قیام نکنید. آزادی معناش این نیست که بنشینید بر خلاف اسلام صحبت کنید.
این مرگ بر آمریکایی که مردم ما میگوین، این مثل همون اعوذ بالله من الشیطان الرجیم است که در اول هر سوره قرآن که شما میخواهید بخوانید قبل از بسم الله اعوذ بالله من الشیطان الرجیم میگید. برای چیست؟ برای اینکه انسان مؤمن یک لحظه حضور شیطان را فراموش نکنه.
مرگ بر اسرائیل.
ما دوستدار همه ملت‌ها هستیم.
We love all nations. We are friends with the Jewish people.
There is tremendous deception in terms of saying one thing publicly and another thing privately. Yasser Arafat obviously was the master of this dual agenda in terms of openly supporting pluralism or non-violence or condemning terrorism.
I condemn completely these terrorist activities.
And then secretly or behind closed doors supporting it.
Sometimes you would find a Muslim who appears to be moderate.
We were the first, as you may remember, post September the 11th, who said that the actions of flying planes full of innocent civilians into buildings is not legitimate.
But in his deeds, he's not as moderate as he is.
We are here to talk about the Magnificent 19. Those who 2 years ago today split the world into two camps, into the camp of Islam and the camp of non-Islam or kufr. Those who revived the obligation of jihad worldwide.
The Magnificent 19, they were praising the hijackers, celebrating the attacks on New York.
People all over the Muslim world admire America, love America, take America as an exemplar in many, many respects.
The Prophet said, war is deceit.
Lying, generally speaking, is not allowed in Islam. But unlike other religions, there are certain situations where a Muslim can lie and that would be acceptable, even encouraged. This concept called التقية. التقية means prevention. So a Muslim is allowed to lie to prevent harm that may come to him or to Islam.
When one is under pressure, one may lie in order to protect the religion. This is taught in the Quran, chapter 3, verse 28, chapter 16, verse 106.
There are certain provisions for lying. So a Muslim can lie for the cause of Islam, can lie to keep peace in his family, so he can lie to his wife. A Muslim can lie to his fellow Muslim to keep peace in the society. Muhammad himself ordered people to lie. When people that he ordered to go and kill somebody, they told him, we cannot kill him unless we lie to that person. He said, okay, fine, lie.
The apostle said, who will rid me of Ibn al-Ashraf? Muhammad bin Maslama, brother of the Bani Abdul Ashal, said, I will deal with him for you, O apostle of God. I will kill him. The apostle said, do so if you can. He said, O apostle of God, we shall have to tell lies. The apostle answered, say what you like, for you are free in the matter. The prophet said, by Allah and Allah willing, if I take an oath and later find something else that is better than that, then I do what is better and expiate my oath.
Они будут видеть наши зрители. Пусть Россия ждет наши зрители, пусть они ждут на их города, везде будут ждать наши зрители.
Ин ашраф аль-маут хуа аль-катл. Ва ашраф аль-катл وأعظم الشهادة هو أن يقتل الإنسان في سبيل الله.
And the teaching in Islamic education is this religion will destroy all other religions through the Islamic Jihad fighters.
الأمريكان ورئيسهم والبريطانيين ومن والاهم والصهاينة ربيبة ومصنع الكيان. الله أكبر. لو أذن الله لنا يا أمة محمد سيقول حتى الحجر يا مسلم هذا يهودي خلفي تعال وقطع رأسه ونحن نقطعها والله لا نقطعها أيها اليهود. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
Human beings are free to choose their own religion. And it is free to
all.
We respect, for example, Christianity. They are free in Iran. Because religious people can never be against other religions.
He loved his country, but never engaged in politics. So why was he kidnapped and so brutally murdered? Is it because he fought for freedom of religion in Iran? A Cry from Iran, Bishop Haik Hovsepian's story, directed by his sons.
He did not use violence. He did not spread violence. He was against violence and was protecting the innocent. That's how he was willing to die. That's what martyrdom is.
A Cry from Iran, coming soon.
Well, the concern that we have here at Voice of the Martyrs and other Christians here in the United States is the status of our Christian brothers and sisters in Iran. They are being arrested. They're being interrogated. In many cases, they're being tortured simply because they are followers of Jesus Christ. And for a Muslim in Iran, there is no other choice than to continue being a Muslim. They simply don't have the freedom to say, okay, I want to follow a different path. I want to follow Jesus.
Islam is superior than the Jews, than the Christians, than the Buddhists, than the Hindus. The only deen Allah accepts is Al-Islam. And whoever seeks any other deen apart from Islam will never be accepted. And the Christians are kafirs. And you may say to yourself, no, 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 they're innocent. No kafir is innocent.
Two blasts just minutes apart, outside two churches in Baghdad, as those inside worshipped.
And you too will meet your destruction, because Allah's religion will prevail on this earth.